All right, coming up next, it's a heavyweight collision between Alexander Gustafsson and Anthony Johnson. Well, we probably trot out the term well-rounded in modern-day mixed martial arts more than we should, but this fighter certainly fits the bill.
Oh, 110%. He can do everything inside the octagon. Where he is most comfortable is inside of that eight-sided structure where most men are terrified of being. But for this gentleman, he only wants to be there. When you try to wrestle him, he's able to defend takedowns. If you dare stand and strike with him, he can knock you out. He's got all the tools necessary to become a UFC champion.
His first martial art, mixed martial arts, and that's not always the case. He believes that he should have a lot of advantages in this matchup tonight. Well, he is the best mixed martial artist that the nation of Sweden has ever produced. Former two-time UFC light heavyweight title challenger Alexander Gustafsson, and he hasn't realized the UFC title yet. But I know you guys will always have UFC 192, one of the harder fights of your career.
One of the toughest nights that I've ever had in the UFC, and Alexander Gustafsson showed in that night that not only is he skilled, he's as tough as they come. From the war with John Jones, to the war that him and I had, to some of the biggest victories that he stood and he's won in the octagon. A very, very skilled striker with fantastic boxing, unbelievable footwork, and very, very underrated wrestling. One of the only guys that can say he's taken me down and also taken John Jones down in a championship fight.
He really is the total package. I know he hasn't solved that John Jones puzzle yet, but truly a special striker. And in terms of the movement at 205 pounds on the feet, nobody does it better than Gus.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 22 wins, 6 losses. He stands 62 inches tall, weighing in at 235 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, Anthony Rumble Johnson! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 18 wins, 8 losses. He stands 6'5" tall, weighing in at 240 pounds. Fighting out of Stockholm, Sweden, Alexander the Baller Gustafsson! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta.
You ready?
So here we go, round one. I can barely hear myself think in this arena right now. Two of the most dominant, well-rounded fighters in the
sport. I mean, these guys are the best of all of mixed martial arts. They can do everything when they're locked inside of the octagon. I'm so excited to watch the highest level of MMA on display tonight.
Well, he's connected on a few hooks so far here in the round, and there it is again. So every time he goes, oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
And he comes knee, through with a big knee.
That knee hurt him.
Knee to the body. Nice defense there. Huge block. Oh, solid leg kicks by Gustafsson. Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes. Ooh, what a punch. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Big right hand lands. Just over 3 minutes to go.
Over and over, he's landing these big body kicks.
So we call on the numbers here. 40 total strikes have landed for Alexander Gustafsson. Oh, how about the hand speed of Alexander Gustafsson in terms of the pressure?
Oh!
Oh, big left. Trying to kick the leg out.
Let's go. Keep moving forward
All right, he's been very clean with his hooks on the feet here tonight, and it's the way that's as good a punch as he's thrown.
The punch that lands down the middle, the one that you don't feel, is the one that lands perfect, and that one landed perfect.
Good series of strikes by him there.
Great job of mixing it up, staying active, keeping busy, doing great work.
Johnson gets hit by that leg kick.
Not only will this affect his ability to stand, but he can't really set down on his punches and he won't generate the power that he normally generates because he can't really get heavy on his leg.
Now connects with a right. Well, plenty of time here to go in round one. He has really gotten off to a good start tonight. He and his corner prioritized an aggressive, all-offense start to this one, and that is exactly the way it's played out. Visibly limping here. Oh, beautiful jab by him there. Got that to the target quickly.
He's dictating the fight with a jab. Look at how he turned his hip into that leg kick.
Johnson's knee attempt here looked like a good one, but it gets blocked.
Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
All right, let's check out some of the action, DC, and how about the punching acumen by that fighter in that previous round?
He does not waste anything. He does not loop punches. Everything's tight. Everything's precise. He's a sniper. We always talk about how he's a sniper. He is a sniper, and it showed in that exchange that allowed him to drop his opponent.
We've seen all night.
Huge straight punch lands, and he's got him hurt very bad.
Well, he continues to land a high number of strikes here, just like he did in the previous round. This is a world-class display of striking here tonight. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Nice jab by him there, and I guess on the other side, hard to get your offense going when your head keeps getting snapped back like a Pez dispenser.
Every time he tries to go forward and use his own offense, the jab is stopping him.
Oh! Oh!
He's working. Serve him up. Go get him. Oh, nice right hand. That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yep. Straight right. Oh! Huge right hand!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves to finish the fight.
He is throwing a fast, straight, hard jab. That's not a feeler jab. That's one that's really knocking the head back.
Very tricky when he throws that body. Yeah, he's mixed it all up. Big kick. You better get that elbow down or he's gonna keep blasting those body kicks right to your ribs. Big liver kick lands under the elbow.
Back and forth we go here.
Over and over and over. He's landing these nasty body kicks.
Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything.
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Right under the elbow, right on the
perfect. It was a perfectly placed shot. You can see his opponent reacting. Why did this hit that punch?
Back to the feet.
Oh, oh, both. Both landed.
Oh, he's out.
Oh!
Beautiful shot to end the fight right there. It couldn't have landed much more flush than it did, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, quite frankly. So, near perfect execution on the strike that ultimately results in the KO here tonight. All right, DC, no Telestrator tonight, but we're going to get you some highlights from this one. This was a fight that had it all, and for my money, his best performance to date.
His best performance to date in the biggest moment. In the biggest moments, you got to show up. And that's exactly what he did tonight. He used every bit of his skill to get the job done.
All right, let's get it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 52 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout, Alexander the Mauler Gustafsson!
Oh, there he is after a huge knockout win tonight. You going to the after party or what?
I mean, I'm heading over there right now, John. I'm asking the producers, how soon can I get up? This is going to be a party over there. Not only because of the knockout, but that extra bonus check is going to be carried to the club tonight.